And I love that little guitar strum.
This one horse town ain't big enough for the both of us.
Yeah, horses.
Checkpoint's still open.
Only got a few hours left until curfew.
Zombie horses suddenly came to mind.
Oh, God. No future, burn it all down. This graffiti is so bleak.
Yep, and there's something by the brown coats again. Little firefly emblem. So we'll be seeing a lot of talk about that, which the fireflies are basically la résistance.
They're the vox populi, the rebels, the...
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's such crap. The soldiers are supposed to handle the outside.
I'll make sure to tell
that guy who was speaking on the left, he's one of the...
You been summoned for this bullshit yet?
Nope.
He's one of the folks who does the main character's voice in, what is it? Binary Domain.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah, as soon as I heard the guy for the first time, I'm like, oh, it's Dan. So what they're talking about is they were getting drafted into labor for stuff, which on occasion they'll grab folks and have them do grunt work, kind of like getting having to go to jury duty. Nobody likes it.
Yeah, kind of chain gangs almost.
Attention. Yeah.
So, unlike a lot of zombie apocalypses like The Walking Dead, I guess there's still some modicum of society.
Well, where we are right now is we're in Boston, and this is a quarantine zone for Boston. You know, they'll refer to it as the zone. So there are pockets of where people are okay, but as post-apocalyptic things are wont to do, nothing really lasts and does too well.
Bullshit! I bet those uniforms over there, they don't get half rations.
Keep your voice down. What's wrong with you?
Whatever, I don't even care anymore. Let them take me. Just be quiet.
So I take it there's still some form of government then, if these are like soldiers.
Yeah, pretty much martial law, which, you know, they're strictly controlling the food. There's a lot of discussion of ration cards, which is kind of the currency, because, you know, you hand those in, you get food. That's what these dudes are waiting for, but oh well. There's a little thing going on up here.
Ooh, some flavor.
Hands on your fucking head. Do it. Alright, scan.
So, things ain't too great if you live inside here.
Apparently not, but it seems pretty sweet if you're one of these CDC guys with their PKE meter.
So, something I kind of like, I don't know if it's intentional, but you do not see many old people.
Oh, shit. Hold her down.
Oh, yeah, I guess that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, which I really like if that was intentional.
Eyes forward.
Because a lot of the folks you see in this, they were, you know, they were kiddos or probably not even born when this whole thing broke out.
Yeah, 20 years, man.
All right, people, this isn't a show. Keep moving along.
Yes, sir. We'll stay put. They're on their way. Shouldn't be long.
So, could I just...
Don't try that again.
I just want to get a look. Come on, let me see. I'll give you...
Let me see. Oh, well then.
Glad that didn't happen.
Oh, man.
So
yeah.
This leads us to something that is a little... subtitles are a must in this game, because sometimes people will be talking and they're really far away from you and their audio will be drowned out. However, there's that kind of works against you right here, because I'm going to walk into a conversation and this one's going to be going in the background. I didn't really notice it until editing. So I'm going to be slapping on subtitles here because it shoves the current one out of the way.
That would never go down here. Any straggler even looks at me the wrong way, I put his ass down. I'm sure that's what they thought at every other QZ before riots broke out.
It's those goddamn fireflies. They keep stirring the population up. We put an end to them. That's how you solve this shit.
We agree on that.
Also, they capitalized the G in goddamn. I'm staying consistent. You see, they're still talking over there.
Oh yeah, that event is still just kind of continuing, independent of you.
Which is wrapping up right now.
What do you think? They beat the shit out of him and dragged him off. Haven't heard from him since.
Fucking idiot. Should have known better.
He's got a family. What's the guy gonna do?
Yeah? How's that working out for him now?
Hey, asshole, what are you looking at?
Ronnie, shut the fuck up, man. Hey, Joel, we're not looking for trouble, okay?
No harm, no foul.
They don't really touch on it too much, but some folks, the folks who do know who Joel is, they are scared of him.
Really? Is Joel a little bit of a bully then, or?
Not really, but we'll find out more later.
Eddie. Here they took Marianne.
What happened?
Came and snatched her in the middle of the night. Said she was a firefly. You believe that shit?
Better not mention the fireflies too loudly. You don't want the wrong person hearing you.
Yeah. Yeah, you're probably right.
That's the last major conversation out here. There are a few you have to talk to folks with a triangle button. Those are special. Others are just walking by, context sensitive.
Yeah, just kind of environmental flavor, really.
Yeah. Which we're going to be seeing all of the triangle ones.
Damn runners came out of nowhere.
Well, that one caught me off guard. I was like, well, what are you talking about?
They got us all new papers. They shouldn't give us any...
Sucks to you. It sucks to be you, bro.
Play cool.
So, presenting paperwork, pass through the checkpoint.
It's a fancy truck.
Mm-hmm. It'd be a shame if something were to happen to it.
What's your business here?
Got the day off. Visiting a friend.
All right, moving through. Thanks.
Well.
Well then. Close it off! Glory to our Stotska.
Yep, pretty much. I would have let Georgie through. I was just curious if anything had happened because they tried to rush you back in.
Yeah, whenever the game wants me to run, I always hang out just to see if it kills me.
Yeah. Which, thankfully, nothing happened. The firefight moved on. The firefight.
Try saying that three times fast.
Firefight. Hallelujah.
So much for the easy route. Patch yourself up, all right?
So the bottom right is our health. This is a but thou must thing. I wanted to hoard this. The game's like, no. No hoarding. Heal now.
They're gonna close.
So in typical video game fashion, you just bandage up your forearm and you're good.
Yeah, I like that, because you can see the bandage on his arm. Also, here's something I really like about this. It's got a little dirty lens sort of look at times, where you're somewhere dark and you're looking at a light source. It looks all smudged and stuff.
Oh, hey.
It's a neat little effect. I really like a lot of the small touches in this.
Hey, how's the east tunnel looking?
It's clear.
I guess that lets the camera feel a bit more integral to the scene, but it does seem pretty weird that you're playing a cameraman, basically following Joel around.
Mm-hmm. Just like one of those little cameras you see in American football games where it's on a zip line.
Couple of zombies making out on this jumbotron. Just like surrounded by a big tacky red heart.
Marlene looking for Robert? What do you make of that?
Gotta use protection, though. You don't want to get an infection.
Swapping spores.
Them cordyceps, man. Oof. They'll tear you up.
This is us.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Shit's stirring up out there. How are we looking over here?
It's been quiet. No signs of military or infected.
That's what I like to hear.
Oh, sorry, not zombies. Infected.
Mm-hmm. Wink. Oh.
Joel, give me a hand with this.
I think you got it. You're a tough lady.
Go on, put your back into it.
What's going on over here?
Just leave her to lean against the TV stand. They're playing some weird hybrid of, like, poker chess.
They're playing checkers with chess pieces, probably.
It's post-apocalyptic Pai Gow is what it is.
I prefer post-apocalyptic backgammon myself.
That's the one that's played with bullet casings and despair.
Wonder what the chutes and ladders or the snakes and ladders equivalent would be.
I think that's the one where you kick somebody into a culvert and see if they make it out.
It's a board game in a different aspect, in a different way. It's B-O-R-E-D, because there's not much else to do.
I live in a very dark post-apocalypse.
Yeah. It's very edgy.
Our backpacks are still here from last time.
I keep seeing Fedra, and I keep on thinking it's saying Fedora.
Well, I mean, come on. They're not monsters.
I'm not allowed to handle.
Your shots count.
There trilby violence. So we got our stuff.
You should have gone for the easy movie reference and said there trilby blood.
I was thinking that, but there's no real tie-in to there's no oil. Also, you'll see right here, our wavy sort of aim goes kind of in a little U shape, a little parabola.
Okay.
But we don't have rock solid aim like our good friend Nathan Drake. But we can work on that more later when it's more relevant. Here's a map of the Boston QZ. There are collectibles in this. I leave it up enough for folks to pause and look at it. There's the fedora, stages of infection.
I'm not seeing any ponytails or neckbeards. So.
Well, the neckbeard is kind of... Okay, here we go. So you have the basics, the runners. You have the stalkers. Then you have the clickers. We'll be seeing them bit by bit. I tend to mix up the runners and the stalkers, honestly. But basically, the longer someone is infected, the more they progress in the stages. That's the general rule of thumb.
So I guess we haven't really talked about where these zombies came from, and I guess it's an infestation by cordyceps spores, which is a real mushroom that that takes over ants' brains or something.
I think that's the one where they climb up on, like, grass, and they get all starey and weird-eyed, and the cow will eat them, and then eventually the cow makes waste, and then eventually the ants eat off that waste, and it all goes in a violent cycle of zombies and ants and cows. No zombie cows, though.
Which, I mean...
Yet!
Be careful.
When am I not?
Got a trick question.
Also, we're in a pizza place. Pizza grapes!
Ooh, pizza grapes. Mmm.
Is that just like a fancy name for like a
Well, I am the romantic.
What's the word?
Got your way.
I think it's a regionalism, like Cabernet Sauvignon.
Oh God, what are those things called? They're tiny hot pocket thingos, little pizza thingos.
Pizza pops.
Pizza pops. That's not it. At least I'm.
Where's the ladder?
Not the
around here somewhere.
The American phrase for them.
Like pizza bites, or they're like little tortellinis full of
people
pizza.
are pulling their hair out right now because I can't remember the name of those pizza snack things.
And I'm foreign, so I don't know.
Pizza rolls, I guess. Is that what it was?
Yeah, they're
yeah,
like those
pizza
little
grapes
dumplings.
Are like pizza rolls. Maybe no.
Ladies first.
I don't know anymore.
I'm just imagining Caligula being fed bunches of pizza pops.
This way.
Just my nubile servant girls.
Elucida!
These are burning the roof of my mouth in the most sensual way.
Let's loot this place.
Alright, I've done
junk!
It.
Junk! Junk!
Oh, yes!
I love his looting animations, because sometimes there are things that are sprinkled all over a cabinet, and he just does these really funny sort of, I'm looting animations.
I like that he went to the same school of engineering as Lara Croft.
Junk, I can do something with this.
Just
also,
gears, I'll turn that into an automatic pistol.
Another collectible. These are Firefly pendants. Dog tags. There's not much really see on them aside from the unique names. That's pretty much it. There's... nothing on the flip side of interest. It was just number fireflies. Also, just kind of looking around some of the graffiti here.
Those must be family members of...
They're all dead.
Oh.
Spoilers.
I'm sad now.
They're all dead.
Down through here. You think Robert still got our guns?
For his sake, he better.
Does that flashlight go on automatically when you go into a dark place?
No. You usually toggle it yourself.
We're meeting Bill next month. More pills, lots of
ammo.
That's
nice. Makes you feel like you're doing something.
I can't remember off the top of my head, but I don't think anything reacts to your flashlight light. I do know that infected don't react to it. I can't remember if humans do or not. I remember it was something that kind of befuddled me, because I was kind of like, oh, I got a flashlight on there. Oh, they're not reacting. The place was
clear last time. So this place is full of mold spores.
Mm-hmm.
Which, is actually a matter of some huge paranoia. Like, I live in Calgary. We had a lot of flooding and stuff, so in affected air. Good God.
Yep.
Keep your eyes and ears open.
Gross.
I love this guy's head model. It looks so funny.
Hi.
But there was a lot of news stories about people just completely paranoid about black mold.
Mm-hmm.
You okay?
Yeah. Damn ceiling's falling apart. Be careful. This way. Easy. Watch it.
Hey, Mr. Man.
My mask broke. Don't leave me to turn. Please.
Take his filters.
What do you want to do?
They're useful, just like in Metro.
Achoom. Oopa. Sorry.
I was stone cold.
So that's the thing. You notice I had 3 shots, now I have 5 shots. Ammo is pretty scarce in this game. Playing on higher difficulties, your resources are stretched even thinner. And the whole shaky aim thing kind of makes it even more difficult. Now, another little mechanic. Joel is like part Daredevil or something. Because...
Oh, he's psychic.
This is a mechanic inside the game that you use to pick up where people are. If you have it on the highest difficulty, I'm pretty sure it's not allowed, I think. Can't remember. Someone will pop in and verify it. I don't care. Anyways, I hugged his neck to death, so he's out of commission. There's still the other two that are nibbling on someone.
So these infected aren't like, dead. They're not zombies.
Well, it's just basically the cordyceps have just taken over their brain and built a nice little colony inside their noodle. So, the best way to handle this is a headshot. I'm gonna get a headshot on this person right here. And it didn't count, what the hell?
What?
So, I decided to stop firing and just do melee. Also, if you get surrounded, you can use L2 to sprint. So the melee is really neat in this, because context-sensitive little things like that.
Oh, cool.
All right, that's all of them.
Let's hope so.
How dangerous is it to arouse the ire of these infected?
Depends upon how many of them there are and what level they are. There's one we will see later on. Actually, several. The strongest ones we run into in the game, if you get in melee range, they will kill you instantly.
Good heavens. So, did I just see you pick up and eat a candy bar?
Mm-hmm. Perfectly safe. Candy bars you have to eat on the spot. Joel does not want to put them in his pockets.
So...
He pulled off his mask, tore it open, ate it, swallowed it, put his mask back on. Not a problem.
Well, bully for him.
Get kind of a, they kind of broke the mold after him. He's pioneer stock.
Oh, absolutely. He's the kind of guy who'd find a 3-week-old dead deer and carve off some of the good meat.
I can use this. Note to brother. So, this poor guy tried to sneak into the zone. Well, they wrote this letter here. Meaning, they were around when the spores were here. Meaning, they got infected.
So they were probably the infected that you just killed.
He was probably among them.
With your meaty fists.
Speak of meaty fists.
You took a swing as you phased through your body in revenge.
Yep. Can't fight her. She's a ghost. So we're starting to get into some of the greenery in the game. There's a lot of brown, but there's also a lot of green. There are a lot of nice little palette changes we'll see in, you know, atmospheres and such.
It's almost chilling seeing these sort of modern day ruins.
Mm-hmm.
Like they have the same sort of feel as like Angkor Wat, you know, just completely swallowed by greenery and stuff.
Angkor Wat.
In Cambodia, you know, like a temple to Buddha kind of thing.
Oh, okay. My mistake. I was thinking like game stuff you're making a reference to, because I was thinking of like Stalker. Or rather, not Stalker, Metro kinda sorta.
Yeah, absolutely.
Also, the whole thing of the spores, it's long-term exposure that kind of turns people.
Plank fell down.
Oh, so eating a mushroomy candy bar won't necessarily make you...
Well, getting bitten, that's, you know, hands down infected. As far as being around a bunch of spores like that, I don't know how long it'd take you to turn or get infected, but probably not much.
Here, pass it to me.
They kind of mention it, but if somebody's infected, they change literally within hours.
Oh.
Yeah, so it's not like it takes time or anything like that. It's like you're infected, okay, you're going to be changing. You know, within a day, you'll be nibbling on your buddies.
It's a bit heavy.
I think I can handle it.
This just builds off the whole ladder thing we saw earlier, where we just pick up and move something.
So I hate to go back to Tomb Raider yet again, but is this sort of the analog to babysitting a flaming torch?
Possibly.
Like you are carrying a long thing to cross a gap?
Let's move.
Possibly. Which Tomb Raider are we talking about here?
The new one.
I can't remember much about that, even though I played it and I loved it. Welp.
Make sure there ain't any
sort of... I'm afraid I can't answer your question, Skippy.
It's clear.
So I'm just an old man forgetting stuff.
I just didn't remember the boring game mechanics of a game that I enjoyed.
I just plumb forgot. I'm but a simple country LP-a. Also, Uncharted had dick things you had to shoot down that are collector items. This is one. Also, look at my ammo. I was like, ooh, don't miss. Thank you.
That is kind of a dick move on.
Welp, I got one shot left. Ben Bluick. Why'd you have to die in a tree, Ben?
I don't even know what his deal is.
I hate Ben so much.
You're just speaking out of anger.
Maybe.
Because Ben's memory cost you a bullet.
Not even worth a bullet.
I'm just really surprised that the Fireflies have such a bureaucratic infrastructure that they were able to assign serial numbers to their, like, rebels.
24601.
Make sure the coast is clear. No soldiers, none of Robert's men.
So what she's giving him right here is a ration card.
A little bit of a bribe.
Yep, getting short round to skirt the perimeter.
You know he's expecting.
No time for love, Dr. Joel.
Well, that'll make it more interesting.
Who knows? Maybe in 20 years, even you may be worth something.
Well, I mean, Joel's still got the watch, so.
Trying to think of a ration card tie-in I could use with no ticket. Okay. Also, yeah, I'm glad you pointed that out. He does still have the watch.
Well, it would be pretty cold of the game to ice his daughter and then not have that have some character implications.
Yeah.
Not bartering for bullets.
Oh, man.
But that was the best part of Deadline's Hell on Earth.
They're gonna go for Metro, the easy one.
For Metro, damn it!
Fried rats! The best of rats. You don't want it underdone, because then that'd be a bad rat.
That one's for you, future friend.
Yep. Nobody likes a bad rat. The easiest joke.
Sorry, man. At least the cheap, though.
Sold out in less than an hour. Try me next
15
week. That's the thing. I'm curious what these dogs are accounted for. Are we talking about snacks, or that's what I'm curious about.
Are they battle dogs? They look pretty excited to see you.
Here's your little puppies.
You want to chill for them cheeks?
You touch it, you buy it.
Yes.
You were looking at the old man kids. With a beard, or?
Can I touch the beard?
Steve Bloom.
So this is what I find kind of weird. Joel's a regular here, but everybody really knows Tess, and nobody seems to know Joel past a point. That's not really explained, and I think it's kind of weird.
I think they might have just gotten confused as to, you know.
Maybe, because it's kind of hinted the two of them worked together a long time, and all these people really know Tess, and Joel's walking around. They're like, whoa, who are you? Also, bum fights.
Maybe they don't recognize him since he grew the beard.
He's always had the beard. He had the beard 20 years ago.
Like, sit back down.
Oh, sorry, Tess. Didn't realize you two were together.
I would not get in the way of a man who looked like that.
Yeah, for real. He looks like he's a swig of Canadian whiskey away from going full lumberjack.
He is wearing a plaid sort of colored shirt. You are correct.
It's true. I mean,
he's not from regular Texas. He's from Sky, Texas. There we go. Also,
now
dude, sharpening a dart, dude sharpening a knife. Not weird.
Nah.
Or machete, I'm sorry. So, when we head over to where Tess is, that takes us to the next little branch of storyline. But we'll probably say that for the next episode. There are some collectibles here, though. Drafting notice. This is for jury duty. Fuck this.
To fuck this.
Mm-hmm. At least you only have to do it once every 6 months.
That's not okay, too bad.
Talking about Robert Horton stuff. Well, let's take a look at this other collectible over here. So remember Firefly? This is the boss of Firefly. Looks a little like Zoe.
Yeah, actually. I wonder if that's
intentional. Got the curly hair and everything. Oh, hey. Hey, kid. What do you got? What is that? Wait, hey. Does it have two heads? Alright, fine.
She is not letting you have a look at that stuffed giraffe.
Oh, well. So, we're gonna end it here, and I'm gonna jump cut over to that, that death reel. Gonna shove and match with a zombie. Nope. Oh, I can keep this up all day.
You turn this into a David Cage game.
Apparently not. Also, a little bit of extra stuff I'm going to mention that I think is kind of neat about that whole thing is you'll notice that a lot of them that were attacking, they were all wearing hospital gowns.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like the outbreak.
Yeah,
so basically, they put them in the hospital, then they turned, then they all went crazy and started attacking people. So that's why most of them were wearing blue dresses.
Hmm.
The end.